giving honor to the Spirit of Christ, pastors, missionaries, brothers and sisters, my family, Mississippi Mass Choir. Just want to say a few words before we go into the spoken word. There is an SOS that's going out all across this country, the world. The president has sent out an SOS, which means save our ship. The mayors of these cities have sent out an SOS, save our ship. Our homes have sent out an SOS, save our ship. Crime in the streets. Ella Butler was just telling me, just over at the temple, having church, lady coming out to a car with all of the security. Young man just snatched a purse right at church. It's an SOS that's going out. And God has deemed it so, and he has chosen Mississippi to send help to the world. And he has chosen you and I. And I'm so glad that you're here. That you are honored. I'm honored to be a servant of the Lord. I want you to envision millions upon millions of people that's going to get help from this album. You got to envision millions of people that's going to look at this, going to be looking at this. So we're going to speak to the ones that you don't see here. We're going to make an appeal to the ones that you don't see here, which will be the multitude. One, if just one of these sermonettes is on BET, look how many millions look at it at one time. Millions are looking at one time, but God is ministering to them one by one. In these sermonettes, there is one for the people that's victimized with AIDS, terminal cancer, terminal diseases. Seemingly, there's no hope. The world has written them off, but God says, I'm going to give you another chance. So this is what this spoken word sermon, our album is all about. Hope and help to the hopeless and helpless. That's what the gospel is all about. So often people know how many times that you fail, but only God knows how many times you've tried. So I want to ask a favor of you tonight. God wants you to have an important role in this. Would you love to help millions of people? God, heaven is calling, is blessing the world. He wants to bless the world through Mississippi here tonight. Oh, I wish you could see what I see. So what I would like for you to do, if you just stand with me, and I'd just like for you to just pray. Pray for me. Pray for this. You have a part in this. And as we were saying, when the altar call is made, maybe there's something you need. Maybe there's something somebody in your family needs. You know somebody that needs help. And as the Lord speak to you, you come. Nobody have to know what you're coming for. That's none of their business. but you come. But I want you to know that I'm gonna make an appeal to the unseen audience. So if it seems like I'm doing something funny, when the Holy Ghost talks to you, you just do what he tells you to do. But I just like a little music, and I just like for everybody to just pray. Just pray out audibly. Can you do that? I know everybody in here can pray. All prayer is talking to God as to a friend. A little prayer, a little power. A lot of prayer, a lot of power. No prayer, no power. So if all of us are praying, how much power is in this room? Don't you want to see souls into God's kingdom? Don't you want to be there? I want to be there. Some son or some daughter is about to overdose, but just to hear a word saying there's help will make a difference. We're praying for our children, praying for others' children, praying for the world. It's so good for us to talk to God. He's missed our conversation. We've been on bad speaking terms because we didn't talk to him, but now tonight we have a chance to talk to him. Our Father in heaven, oh Jesus, send the Holy Ghost to take the steering wheel of this message and guide it, Lord, that souls might be garnered into your kingdom. Help us, oh Lord, in Jesus' name. Timothy 3:1 says, This know ye also, that in the last days perilous times shall come. No way out, seemingly. When we turn on the TV, mostly all we see is bad news. When we turn on the radio, mostly all we hear is bad news. When we pick up the newspaper, mostly all we read is bad news. One might ask, what meaneth these things? What can one do? What's wrong? John 1:1 says that in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. What's likened to the Word? Jeremiah 23:29 says, is not my word as fire, saith the Lord, and like a hammer that breaketh the rock into pieces. I tell you what we need and what meaneth these things. The Lord is saying to you and me, it's hammer time. Not MC Hammer, but JC Hammer. Notice what Jesus the Hammer says in Isaiah 57:15. He said, for thus saith the high and lofty one, one that inhabiteth eternity, whose name is holy. I dwell in the high and holy place. With him also is of a contrite and humble spirit, to revive the spirit of the humble, and to revive the heart of the contrite ones. Here the Lord says, I'm so big, I can make myself so huge. Heaven really couldn't hold me. But if you humble yourself, I can make myself so minute, so small, I can make my abode in the confines of your little heart. And why he want to come into our hearts to revive us, I tell you, it's hammer time. Like, will you just help me? Where's the hammer time? In our home, it's hammer time. In our church, it's in the school, it's in the community, in the White House, in the mayor's house, in the poor house, in the rich house, in your house, in my house. Can hammer time begin? The moment I open up and let the hammer come in, then hammer time begins. Want you to know that a hammer can destroy, and a hammer can also build. He wants to tear down sin in our lives and build up a life of righteousness, a life that we can act like God, talk like God, walk like God, think like God. I tell you, it's hammer time. All you gotta do is just let the hammer in wherever you are. Now, why don't you just let him come in? Oh, the hammer, JC Hammer, wants to do something for you. How about it?
Come into my
in your heart. You can set in motion the things of God. He can recharge you. He can put new breath in your life. He can encourage you. Anybody need encouraging? Why don't you come? Why don't you come? Don't you just come down and stand for them? Say, oh Lord, do something for my child. Do something for my husband. Do something for my wife. Do something for my brother, my sister. What you need, He'll make all the difference. He'll give you that boost, that lift that you need. I'm talking about the hammer, the real hammer. MC can't change your heart, but JC can. MC can't heal you, but JC can. MC can't save you, but JC can. Let him do it. Let him do it. Let him do it. Let him do it.
Come in to my heart.
Jesus. Mr. J.C. Hammer. Thank you, Lord, for coming into our hearts. Thank you for coming in the room. Oh, bless Lord. May no one be omitted. Oh, bless Lord. Wherever this is heard or seen, bless me, pray. Bless these your people. When it's all over, save us in your kingdom. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God bless you. Jesus, send the Holy Ghost in our games of life and make us all winners for eternity. In Jesus' name we pray. In Luke 15, 11 through 24, we find the story of the prodigal son, whom I call the superstar of an athlete. My thought is he walked, he struck out, he hit a home run. One day he came to his father and said, "Give me my proportion of my goods that falleth to me." So he got his portion, packed up, left home. He walked, as it were, church. But he came to the bat again. He went into a far country. Strike one. Spent all of his money in riotous living. Strike two. Wind up in the pig pen. How low can you go? Strike three. But while there, he came to himself. And he had a chance to come to the bat again. And he said, "I'll rise and I'll go to my father. Don't have to be a son, just a hired servant." So he rose. And he went home, and his father accepted him with open arms. In addition to this, I'm reminded of a certain city I went to one day, and I found out that a minister friend of mine had shot his wife. I went to the hospital to see her. She was in intensive care. And she said, "Tubes up her nose, needles in her arms." But she was able to look into my face, and she smiled, and she was able to say this: "Thank you for coming. God has taken care of me, but my husband needs you. He's in jail." So I went to the jail, went in the room, And he looked at me and said, oh, I thank you for coming. All my other friends have left me. He said, but preacher, I got a little something I want to tell you. Say, you know, I left the Lord. Left my church. He walked church. Said, but then I start drinking. Strike one. Then I went and start chasing women all I could find. Strike two. And then tried to take my own wife's life. Strike three. How low can you go? And they put me in this jail. And I began to cry to the Lord. And one night the Lord came in the jail saying, and he gave me the assurance that he had forgiven me. And I began to talk to God and started praying, started preaching. And the inmates began to laugh at me. But I kept on preaching and asked God to give me my preaching power back. Kept on preaching, finally one came. Then two came. And now, preacher, everybody chimes in with me now. Want you to know that all the years I preached when I was outside free, my ministry's never blossomed like it has in this jail. Say it. Two or three weeks later, I got a call. They said, preacher, guess where I am? I said, where are you? I said, I'm home taking care of wife. He hit a home run from the jail cell, church. You just listening and looking, maybe you've walked away from God. Maybe you've struck out. But wherever you are, you can hit a home run right now. You can hit a home run. got you right here. You want to come? You want to come for one of your children again? How about it? Did you not know you can have a child a long way away from home? Sometime the Lord got to make him broke, make him sick, in order for him to come home. The young man had to lose all he had, but it brought him home. The preacher had to go to jail. Almost took his wife alive. He lost her. Even he couldn't look himself in the eye, in the face, in the mirror. But one night he saw Jesus and he hit a home run. You can hit a home run right now. When you want the Lord to bring your children home, why don't you try it? Better time than now. If not you, who? Not now, when? Yes. Yes, 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 yes. In heaven, oh Lord, thank you for bringing us home. Oh, reach out. Those that have left, Lord, bring them back home. Touch them right now, Lord. Somebody is in a bad situation right now. Oh Lord, bring them home. Somebody's discouraged, oh Lord, bring them home. Family problems. Oh Lord, they've lost their self-respect. Happen to know, Lord, that you're right there with your arms wide open. Oh, help them, Lord. Bless them. Those that these have stood up for, oh Lord, reach them wherever they are. Reach out. Bring them home. Your eternal home, oh Lord. Thank you, thank you. We'll be careful to praise you throughout eternity. Thank you, oh Lord, in Jesus' name.
Oh,
in heaven. Oh, Jesus, may the blood that was drawn from your veins on Mount Calvary come very fresh and alive to us right now. Wherever we are, oh Lord, may the blood touch. In Jesus' name. My name is Cocaine. They call me Coke for short. I can enter your home, school, church, community, job, country without a passport. I've caused many people to think they were rich. Some have been killed and found in a ditch. I'm more valued than diamonds. More treasure than much fine gold. Use me just once, and you too will be sold. You don't know me. I am the big C. I'll make mothers leave home and forsake their suckling child. They'll roam the streets and cause their children to run wild. I'll make those in school forget their books. I'll make a Miss America forget her looks. I can take a world traveler, truck driver, pilot or explorer, forget their route. I'll take your fathers, mothers, sons and daughters, and make them a prostitute. You don't know me. I am the big C. I can make school teachers forget how to teach. I can make preachers forget what to preach. I'll take your house number, rent money, and you'll be evicted. I'll murder your babies, or they'll be born afflicted. I'll make you rob, steal, cheat, and kill. When you're under my power, you'll have no will. Remember, my friend, I am the big C. If you try me just once, you may never be free. I've destroyed preachers, teachers, doctors, lawyers, actors, athletes, superstars, executives, men, women, boys, and girls, common, professional, and many a hero. I've reduced bank accounts from millions to zero. You don't know me. I am the big C. But oh, my friend, there's another voice that's saying to you and to me, you need to know me. For I am the real big C. I am the heavenly coat that came down and died on Calvary's tree. Coat, C-O-K-E, Christ our King eternally. The real thing. All of your sins and your burdens and problems you can bring. To just say no is not enough, you see. Until in your heart you've said yes to me. I am the captain of the old Zion ship on life's tempestuous sea. I don't care what you've done, where you've been, where you are. Just come unto me. Open your heart's door. Please let me come in, and I'll surely set you free. You don't have to worry about nicotine, caffeine, fright, smile, pop, meth, white, Chinese white, alcohol and ice. 'Cause I've already conquered for you with my blood sacrifice. I'm the way, the truth, the life, all three. I'm Jesus Christ, the best thing that came out of heaven and Nazareth. Whatever you need, I am that I am. My blood will surely set you free. I'm the real Big C. It's available wherever you are. Maybe you're the head of the corporate ladder. Maybe you're a great business, big business tycoon, superstar, highly professional, in an ivory tower. Maybe you're a physician, a doctor, that somehow you got hooked on the drugs that you administer to your own patients. But I want you to know that the blood reaches to the highest mountain. Maybe you're down in the gutter. The world has written you off. You're no longer even a member. You can't even look in the mirror at yourself. But I want you to know that the blood flows to the lowest valley. It'll reach you wherever you are. Stand for them. How about you just looking on? Right now you can be set free. The blood is efficacious, man. This book is alive. It's able. All you gotta do is say, help me, Lord, help me. sell your fix. Why not ask God to fix you? And I guarantee you, He'll give you a high that you never had before. All you gotta do is just stand on it and get high. Don't cost you nothing. He's already paid the price. Anybody else want to stand in for somebody? Huh? You got a neighbor you know on drugs? How about your neighborhood? Your neighborhood free from drugs? Drugs in our school. How about it? Wherever this is heard, wherever this is seen, oh, bless, we pray. Oh, touch, Lord. Send your blood on an errand of mercy and love. Oh, Lord, clean up lives, we pray. Reach our sons and our daughters, our husbands, our wives, whoever. Oh, Lord, help. Lord, we've stood in for friends of ours. Oh, Lord, bless, we pray. Oh, Lord, that somebody at the office, at the home, can't make it without drugs. Oh, Lord, give them a fix right now. Bless in a mighty way. And, Lord, not only a fix for today, a fix for eternity. In Jesus' name we pray.
Ah!
our Father in heaven. Oh, Jesus, come touch wherever this message is heard. Touch, O Lord. Send help everywhere. Those Lord that's about to breathe their last breath. Oh, touch, O Lord. A touch for eternity. Give them comfort and assurance. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Matthew 1:8-3 and Mark 1:40-43. We find the story of the leper. In days of old, leprosy was somewhat like AIDS of today. There was no cure, no help to be found anywhere. When one had leprosy, he had to leave his family, leave his loved ones. He was isolated from society. The agony of being separated from those that's so close to you. Just waiting to die. A death row experience, if you please. But one day at the foot of the mountain, there was a large crowd gathered. There was gathered around a young preacher. He was healing the sick, giving sight to the blind. The dumb began to speak. The deaf began to hear. The lame began to walk. Jesus was conducting a healing campaign. He was performing surgery with words, a look, and a touch. All of a sudden, there was a cry out of the valley saying, "Unclean! Unclean!" A leper had heard that Jesus was in the vicinity. And somehow he'd gotten out of the leper camp. He's trying to find Jesus, in whom he believed could help him. So he cried, "Unclean! Unclean!" The crowd was horrified. They were asking, where did he come from? How did he get out of the leper camp? He is an offense to us. But he kept on coming, crying, "Unclean, unclean." Every step he took was painful. Every step he took, he would leave a little blot of blood. And every breath he would touch, he would leave a little rotten flesh. Sometime a finger would fall off. A toe would fall off, but he kept on coming. Crying, "Unclean, unclean, unclean." Everybody left Jesus. But he got in the immediate presence of our Lord. And Jesus said, "Son, what would you have me to do?" He said, "Lord, thou can make me clean." And Jesus touched him. And his skin became like a newborn baby. The fingers that he had lost on his hand came back. The toes that he'd lost on his feet came back. And ever since that day, when those that knew the leper, when they saw him, that that's what happened. And he would simply say three words: he touched me. Maybe you have AIDS wherever you are. Whether it's your fault or not, don't worry about it. Just let him touch you. Maybe you're a cancer patient. The doctor cut you open and he saw that there's no hope in his own job. But I want you to know he can touch you. Looking and listening, maybe you're a diabetic. Both of your legs have been amputated. You've lost your eyesight. But I want you to know, let him touch you. He have a brand new pair of legs waiting on you. Have eyesight. Some eyes that have never needed glasses again. To let him touch you. Somebody told me a while ago, said they had a loved one gravely ill. I said, if you could just hold on, the next appeal, if you could just hold on, God is touching right now. You have a loved one need to be touched. Why don't you try? Wherever you are, let him touch you. I want to cut this off, but I can't because somebody need to come out here and stand for somebody.
I know the joy.
Father in heaven, oh Lord, thank you for the touch. Oh Lord, that sister, that brother, that can hear this. The doctors have done all that they could do. That brother, that sister that has AIDS and the world society has turned their back on you. Oh Lord. Let them know that you're the God of another chance, oh Lord. All they gotta do is say, unclean, unclean. Say, sin, Lord, I'm sorry. Oh, forgive me. Oh Lord. Happen to know that's what you came and died for. For our mistakes, for our sins, our shortcomings. Lord, bless everywhere. And we pray that the touch right now would be an eternal touch. That when we get around your throne, we can bask in the joy of when you touched us. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you for the touch. Thank you for touching in this room. Reach out and touch, Lord, those that stood in for somebody else. Oh, thank you. Oh, bless, 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 oh Lord. Somebody sick, touch, heal, or we pray. Oh, touch. We'll be careful to praise you throughout eternity. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Father in heaven. Oh, Jesus. May our cups overfill with gratitude. May the Holy Ghost help us and remind us of how good you are and how good you've been to us. Over, Lord. So much that it would gladden some sad soul. Come and bless now in a special way. In Jesus' name we pray. In a small town in Georgia, just north of the Okefenokee Swamp, little place called Waycross, funny name, Railroad Center, where I was born and raised. My mother resides there. She wanted to be here. She's in her 80s, but she called and prayed. When my family and I, when we go home, mother would always wait up in the rocking chair, waiting for everybody to go to sleep so we could have our little prayer. So one night, I never will forget, way after midnight, I said, "Mother, are you ready?" She said, "I'm waiting on you, son." She was waiting to pray. So I prayed first, because I know she always pray an hour. So I had to go and get mine out of the way. But this particular night, Mother prayed an unusual prayer. A prayer that I'd never heard before. It was a prayer of gratitude. She didn't ask God for nothing, she only thanked Him. Started off something like this. She said, "Dear Jesus, I want to thank you for life, health, and strength. My family and my friends and loved ones. As we were on our knees praying, her prayers began to give me a walk from the present to the past. We grew up in a three-room house, and I didn't say three bedrooms. Six in the family lived in town, but we didn't have the modern conveniences that our neighbors had. But we had food, we had clothing, we had somewhat of a shelter, and we had a whole lot of love. So my mother now moved from the old house into a new house. Right there on Brandon Street, my mother, Arlene Cone. She said, "Thank you, Lord, for this solid, dry roof on this house and these stout, warm walls, unlike the old house. Whenever it rained, we had to get the pots and the pans and buckets to catch the water. And these stout walls, whenever the wind would blow, we could feel in every room, we could feel the wind. Thank you, Lord." "I want to thank you for these electric lights. Unlike the old house where we had to trim the lamps, burn the candles, Lord, and for the water that's coming through the walls, through the pipes. I want to thank you. Unlike the old house where we had to prime the pump, pump the water, bring it in. And for this electric stove, oh Lord, I thank you. Unlike the old house where we had to go to the mill, load the wood on a wagon to bring it home and cut it up, build a fire. Thank you, Lord. But all I have to do here is just turn a knob, start cooking. Lord, and I want to thank you for this refrigerator in this kitchen. Unlike the old house where we had to get 50 pounds of ice. And she took a walk in the bathroom. We were on our knees, but we were walking. She said, Lord, I just want to thank you for this bathroom. With tub, shower, sink, and commode. Unlike the old house. Got ready to take a bath, we had to prime the pump, pump the water, bring the water in the number three tub and take a bath. Not to mention the commode, Lord. Where we had to go out back. Had to find the mosquitoes and sometimes fight the snakes. Thank you, Lord. It looked like she passed by the washing machine in the dryer. Said, Lord, I just want to thank you for the washer and the dryer. Unlike the old house. Where we had to prime the pump, pump the water, and three number three tubs and had a rub boat. Had an old black wash pot. We had to fire up and had a poking stick. Oh, Lord, thank you. And this dryer, oh, Lord, it's so convenient. The old house, we had to hang them on the clothesline and had to take the clothespin and pin every garment. Thank you, Lord. And Lord, I want to thank you for this last child of mine down here on his knees with me. The worst one I had. Stayed in the streets. Every time I hear a siren, I thought somebody, it was him. Somebody blown his head off or cut his heart out. But Lord, he's on his knees with me. Thank you for hearing my prayer, Lord. And now he's one of your preachers. Lord, I just want to thank you. And then she went up the road a little piece. She said, Lord, I thank you so much for this house. But I read in your word that you got another house for me. And in this house, we'll never know deterioration. This house, I won't have to pay any taxes. This house, I won't have to pay no water bill. This house, I won't have to pay no light bill. This house. This house won't have to worry about my neighbors leaving me dying. This house won't hear no sirens. This house. Lord, thank you for making my reservation. I'm just waiting, Lord, and I'm thanking you. I'm thanking the Lord. Maybe somebody like to join me and just thank him. I'm already down here. I'm thanking him for what he's done for me. Anybody else want to thank him? How about you that's looking? Do you want to thank him? Father in heaven, we thank you, Lord. Thank you for using us to bless your people everywhere. Thank you, O Lord. Oh, Lord, go with us now. Help us to thank you every day of our life. Thank you for what has transpired here. May God winds of love and mercy to be a blessing to others everywhere. One day we'll tell the story throughout eternity. What happened here, you blessed people everywhere. May the Lord bless thee, may the Lord keep thee. May the Lord make his face to shine upon thee and give you his peace, now, henceforth, and forevermore. In Jesus' name we pray.
Say praise the Lord again.
Praise the Lord.
Can we say thank you? Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, let's just thank him. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, thank you. Come on, sing it with me.